Hello and welcome back to the Risk of Rain 2 Challenge Series. The previous recording of us getting the cleaned up challenge in our logbook was corrupted. We went and looked at it. Fortunately, it's quite an easy one to get. We continued on to the next level where we went to the Sky Meadows and we just destroyed 20 meteors. Probably one of the easiest achievements to get. The only difficult part about that is actually getting to the Sky Meadows. And I don't believe there was anything else that we had unlocked. Awesome. Okay, so we will go back and we will go straight into the single player and see what we can unlock today. Jump in with Loader just because we feel like it. And we might want to start doing some of the character or the survivor logbooks challenges. Because we are running out. We can also aim for flawless. Fully charge a teleporter without getting hit. This is a definitely a difficult one. And easy is done by actually completing the... Where have we got it? Unlocking the mercenary is actually what we might want to do by doing true respirate. Okay. So what we need to do for that is we need to get all the way back around to stage 3 or stage 4, if I remember right, on loop 1, which means we need to go all the way to the start and go a little bit further. So we'll jump in with Loader for that. And then that's how we unlock the mercenary. We might be completing that today, or we might be getting some more of the Lunar Shrines. We've got some crit glasses just out of over here, and one, two chests over there as well. We can hear a golem, but we cannot see a golem. Okay, we can't see any more easy to get chests. We'll look for the teleporter. There's one chest up there, a large chest down here, and a chest at the back, which is where the teleporter probably is as well. Yep. Okay, so we'll be aiming to get about 75 gold from the teleporter event. Thank you. little bit of a cheese there to dodge some damage, but still effective. Our damage is definitely very high with the two focus crystals. Having these giant numbers come out, two shotting lunarians. Just saw in the corner of our eye, and a chest down there behind the rock. And another chest over behind the tree. Awesome. We did have a multi-shot down there, but I think we will have to leave it there. It's not a game that I am playing. My love, try to hold my feeling, I don't know what's right. I'll find the best way, I think that I might. Okay, I'm very slightly the Genesis loop come in use. Great. Although Kara's Bend is great, extra attack speed goes really well on load-up. Teleporter, great. blazing out. Resonance disc is quite useful for loader to help with the wave clear, and we'll get some more crit blasts. Scanning to see if there's any chests on this ledge. See if there's any down that valley. Doing an alright time so far for the Wisped Acres. Let's head on over this way. Do have to grab a Wisp very early, always useful. Come back and grab some chests.
I'm holding on for you to come around.
One more.
I've waited for so long, I've run aground. I feel I'm burning up inside. Oh, hear me quiet. I feel like everyone's alive. And I am dying.
Back on track, had a little bit of a detour off island, but it's good to get back. Down near the teleporter, have we got one chest? One multi chest on this side of the teleporter. Incinerator. Couple on this side of other than that, normally there isn't a bridge connecting, and you don't have a chest option, but there is potential. We've got a magic shop and a chest. And another chest. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 chests to open. Or 2 chests, 2 multi shops. We want about 400 gold. Boss. We have 2 temples here that we have to be very careful of. Boss damage, because we are wanting to loop all the way around, so we need a lot of boss damage. We'll have many to kill. And let's go. Probably are wanting to get some more infusion, get a little bit more base health going, and if we can get another red item, that would be great. Barrels, eggs. Having another red item. Frost Relic is great for loader. Any melee character is great with the Frost Relic. There's that fellow dead. Go find some more chests. Let's open up some more white items, hopefully. Find some more eggs. Get that boss sword. The sooner we can do that, the less time we waste. Okay, we're going to go down. No chests down here. And back up. So we've got the teleporter and many chests in here. No eggs. So we can assume that they are all up high. Probably out on some further wings. I think we will go for the razor wire here, get some more thorns damage. Still not seeing any eggs along this side. Not up the back here either. Guillotine here to execute our elites. More white items. Attack speed is great. There's another egg here we can get. We need one more to go, and it could quite potentially be on top of this building. There it is. Last egg. I think we will be grabbing a fuel cell when we have enough income for that. So for now, we will just get some boss damage on. Now that we have burning and the we have the frost relic, we can just swing around this alloy worship unit and continue to charge into it, but hold down your right click, and if you don't slingshot too far away, you won't snap the tether, allowing you to deal considerably large amounts of damage to it. If we grabbed a shattered hammer from that boss, I probably would have gotten death mark. But by the looks of it, it didn't. Yeah, we didn't have shattered hammer, we have alien. Which is perfectly fine for loading, getting more cooldown on everything, getting more cooldown on the grapple, more cooldown on the power slam. We'll be right back. Frost Relic does crazy amounts of damage to the worm, as you can hit multiple parts of worm at the same time. So most AoE builds do the same AoE good against the Magma Worm. And it is very useful to know that the Magma Worm is a renowned build. And if you guys haven't noticed, the Resonant Disc is dealing enough damage to continually knock itself. We essentially just get to sit back, and the Resonance Disc is just sniping enemies across the map through walls. It's great. This is in part effect to the Guillotine as well, because the Guillotine is giving the Resonance Disc more damage. Combining that with Gasoline, so after they take the initial mana damage and put them inside the Threshold, they won't actually die from the Resonance Disc. Can't one-shot them elite, unless you have purely enough damage to do it. But you can two-shot them by putting them in Threshold and giving them one tick of any other damage. So that's like Resonance Disc, that's Fuel Cell, that's Gasoline, anything like that. Even if it's just one bit of damage, if they're inside the Threshold, then they get executed. So if you are in a contest when you're in multiplayer, trying to outdeal your friend's damage, having a guillotine build is not the quickest way to kill people, but it can sure do a lot of damage. And guillotines are extremely useful against Horde of Many bosses, because most of the time they are elites. As awesome as Sawmerang is, we're going to stick with the Disposable Missile Launcher. It's one of my preferred equipment items. It does a great job. Okay, we're very lucky there to have spawned some blazing parents. Our only saving grace being our Resonance Disc down the line. Okay, now that we've got the parents in this little row here, we do have a chance to roll them, since we are very likely to continually hit our charged attack. We do just have to be exceedingly careful, because the parents deal a crazy amount of damage. See that the game does give a little bit of compensation for how overpowered the pants are, like how much gold you get for killing them. Okay, so we haven't got any chests here, we're going to grab. Oh, there was one chest over there actually. Gonna look at the top here, no chests here. So we'll just go back down the bottom, and then we'll go look at getting into the teleporter. We have not got much sprint speed, so we're really hoping to get some more wild items and get some sprint speed. Okay, this is a little bit risky. We have been clearing the bosses quite well so far as Loader, so we will activate a mountain shrine. Lions roaring in the morning, our Lepton Daisy sun could very well save us. And we'll clear out these shrines before we go through to the boss, like just because we have so much money. Just come. We must never stop the way, yeah. Savannah, I'm coming home. Savannah, we'll never be alone. Savannah, okay, up to the temple we go. Savannah, we do have a couple of shrines to return to if we have a crazy amount of excess money that we do want to spend. Some elder Lemurians that we can funnel up this pathway. So what we want to do is get our charged attack, come down and slam through them all. We quite horribly failed that slam, but we have another shot. Go. We deal insane amounts of AoE damage when enemies are grouped. And we took heavy advantage of that. Also not now have 4 guillotines, which means we are executing within quite a decent threshold of health. Almost half health, as you can see when I hover over a loot monster. Which means we only really need to be doing half the amount of damage to take out such a strong monster. We will activate this new portal if we can. Normally you cannot activate them inside the teleporter event, but that one did not have a barricade on it. So just stay inside the range and finish up the charge. Almost there. I'm coming home, Savannah. We'll never be alone, Savannah. Okay, there's our charge done. We'll head over to our shrines. Gasoline for some more devastating AoE damage. What happens next? How far can we get if we sail a little bit higher? Our resonance disc's still dealing crazy damage, and our RNG severely failing right here. Level. We have now looped back to stage one. Now, since we're on our first loop, enemies become a lot more difficult. Our biggest advantage being we are very strong. Want everything to do with shields, so Topaz shield is greater than personal shield generator nowadays, since we're killing so many enemies, and you get a shield per enemy killed with Topaz brooch. Okay, we have a fair amount of regeneration, so we can just pop this for a little bit of gold, enough to get one whole chest. Clean up all the chests in the area as quickly as we can. Gorn's Tome isn't as useful as it comes later into the game, because the gold you get from killing monsters is sometimes more than the gold you'll get from the nuggets. But it can have its own effects. Because when you're killing large amounts of monsters, eventually you're just picking up more and more nuggets, and that is useful. So we just want to keep sweeping around the level as quick as we can. Up and down. So we are just ramming for items. Up our first Stone Titans this match. And very easily dealt with. As we can see, Alien Head's been extremely useful. There's barely ever been a situation where we don't have charge to slam to deal with an enemy. And as you've seen me do many times so far, but you might not have recognized what exactly it is I'm using Hoppo Feather to cancel my mid-air momentum. So if I shoot and I jump with Hoppo Feather, I can cancel a fair amount of my mid-air jumping and stay in an area that I want to be in. Because my Frost Relic is dealing a large amount of my damage. Okay, we didn't see our roster buff box there until all the way at the end, so we didn't grab that one, but that's okay. We only have one key. It would have been a white item, which is what we do need. We definitely need some more crit. We've only got 30% so far. But it's okay. And we need a lot more movement speed. We have got very low movement speed for being in stage 7 of the game. Okay, we have our first Malachite unit in this run. Malachites are extremely dangerous because if you get one of their bullets, they will not only deal a crazy amount of damage, but they will also stop all of your regeneration for a couple of seconds, which is very important because later on into the game, regeneration is the way you sustain your health. So the item we're looking for from the equipment chest is we're looking for a Prayon. Because that is a great late game active item, which does a large amount of damage. Which is scouting for chests. Because we want to spend as little time on April as we can. Okay, we have a Templar around the corner here. Deal with him before he might kill us later. And we've got a little bit of gold here with this Frozen Leap. So now that will give us enough to go and get large chests. Some teddy bears here. Have we got any teddy bears so far into the build? No, we have not. Very surprisingly. We definitely will pick up, I think, at least 3 teddy bears. We haven't got many whites so far this run, so it is unfortunate. Every white that we've lost so far has been one that we do want to try and hold on to. We have the 3 teddy bears that I was after. Head over to this chest. Okay, we're going to head over to this new shrine and inactivate it. There we go. We have a large chest around here that was hiding from us. Okay, we got Blockade Breaker for killing 15 boss monsters in one single run. This is what we were aiming to do with our commando runs before our recording glitch. We're going to take some longer late game achievements. So this is what we will do with our loader. We will again continue this run. We will pause the recording at the end of this teleporter event and take this run further into the game. Okay. Thank you for watching this for the Create Gaming. We'll catch you again in the next episode where we will continue on the other side of this blue portal.